Hey guys, I hope you're all doing really well. Today I'm going to venture out and run a few errands. I need to purchase a few things. I need some more masking tape to work on this painting here. What else do I need? I need to pick up a print from the printing store and drop it to the person. So a couple of friends of mine recently lost their dog. Quite sad because this dog was an extremely beautiful, funny, still fairly young dog. And unfortunately, an accident occurred one evening and the dog didn't survive. Best way I can look at it is that this dog lived an extremely adventurous life while she was here on Earth. She has a very adventurous mother and father who took her out often on the boat. She went fishing, she went camping, she lived her best dog life here in the Kimberley. Anyway, her sister messaged me on Instagram and said, hey, can I commission you to do this print of the dog? Are you able to add some of the ocean in it as the background and a bandana with the Salty Sessions crew on it, because that is their own little thing they have going on. It's really cool. I also added a fish because this dog, when she was around, really enjoyed eating fish. She went fishing a lot with her father, so she'd get involved in that process. Yeah, so I would like to go to the op shops, aka thrifting. However, I don't think they're open as of yet because of COVID, so we'll see. I'd also like to see if the art store has some resin and some tie-dye, because I'd like to tie-dye. I have bought a few of these shirts and I'd like to tie-dye them. They're literally boys' shirts from Target for about, I think you get 3 in a pack for $8, so there's a little tip for you. So yeah, let's hit the road, Jack. But we'll be coming back. COVID period break, and it is important to get them all back on their feet so that we don't lose them, because we love them.
Hey guys, so I just returned from the shops. Few detours,
Bunnings was chockers. So I can go to Bunnings and get my paint scraper that I really wanted to get to scrape off paint off palettes. So it doesn't matter. I got the masking tape, which I needed, and I got some other things that I possibly don't need, but I wanted. I got some resin from the art store. You'll see what I'm gonna do with this later. Oh, screw it. I'm going to cover this with resin and glitter. I know some of you are probably thinking, what are you doing with that piece? And I don't know, but we're getting there. It's really just all the things I want to do and the things I like visually looking at. Glitter, fluoro, 80s, all that stuff kind of excites me visually. I got some tissue paper to package my prints. I want to look into using tissue paper versus plastic, even though this is covered in plastic. Trying to find more eco-friendly ways to package my art. Although it's kind of hard because these gloss prints really can't afford to have fingerprints and dust and stuff stick to them. We shall see. On that note, I picked up the print. This is Miss Oi. Her name was Oi, also known as Oiza. I'm going to drop this off to her owner's house today. I also got this. I've needed one of these for a while. It is just a plastic palette, but it's flat. So this is going to make it much easier for me when I have dried paint on it. I will use a scraper to scrape it off, start again when I do a new painting. The other thing which was really not planned is this guy here. Essentially, it's a easel that stores pencils, paint brushes. I would like to do a bit of travel soon in the year once the borders open, and yeah, so, and I would like to take my painting supplies with me. I would love to do some landscape paintings because the outback in the Kimberley is just visually stunning. Cool beans. So I'm going to now package this thing up. Okay, so I'm going to head out now and I'm going to drop this off. I'm gonna jump in the car and get a movie. I might clean this mess up when I return home so I can complete this painting with a clear working space and a clear mind. Bye.